Hello, I'm dentist in Korea, Dr. Dan. Today I want to share about cephalometric analysis, in especially Down's analysis. We can review of uses of cephalogram. We can get the useful information about skeletal dental abnormalities. Mainly sagittal. Of course, we have AP view, but mainly we can get information from sagittal view. I want to emphasize the main informations. That is extraction or non-extraction. It is very critical decision making point, and surgical or non-surgical. Relatively, it is easy decision, and we can get evaluation of treatment result and research. It is important in my case. I can improve my clinical skills and knowledge from evaluation of treatment result and I can research deeply, very deeply, I think. So someone say cephalogram is useless, but in my case, it is a useful tool. Okay, let's get started to Downs analysis. Dr. Downs, many people misunderstood the Downs name. His name is Downs. Is not Down. Downs. He published 1948 published comprehensive analysis. It is first published cephalometric analysis, but in Europe, Bjork in 1947. He also published cephalometric analysis, but in general, we accept the Downs analysis is first published analysis. Okay, he analyzed 20 Caucasians. The average age is 12 to 17 years, and he divided the five skeletal and five dental categories. And he uses the standard plane as FH plane as standard plane in cranial base. And he emphasized balance of the face is determined by the position of the mandible. Okay. He is, that is Brody, Dr. Brody. He is a disciple, he was a disciple of Engel. He attended Engel school. And he, in University of Illinois in Chicago, she made the Department of Orthodontics. And his orthodontic department is considered as a military academy, like West Point in Army. He made many, he trained many doctors as an orthodontist, and they spread out in USA. Okay, so Downs was one of them. The Downs was a disciple of Brody, Dr. Brody. Dr. Brody majored in anatomy. He also majored in anatomy. Of course, he majored in orthodontics, but he made an article about anatomy and he got a PhD degree. Okay, go back to the Downs analysis. First, facial, he uses facial angle. Facial angle is constructed by nasion, A point, and pogonion. Average value is about 90 degrees. This is facial. I mistook. I will correct. Nasion and pogonion is the facial plane, and this is APH plane. The angle between facial plane and FH plane and facial angle, this is a facial angle. It is about 90 degrees. Interpretation as follows. Increased in skeletal cleft 3 with prominent chin and decreased in skeletal 2. It is very easy to assess the facial angle. And angle of convexity. This is the relative position of maxilla and mandible, and nasion, A point, and pogonion, nasion, A point, pogonion. And in general, that 0 degree, it means the trait profile. Okay. And mandibular plane angle, and the high angle means hyperdivergent face. And mandibular plane angle is about 22 degrees, similar to angles, mandibular plane angle. FMA, Frankfurt mandibular plane angle, FMA, both are similar measure. And y-axis, the cella to nasion, and the between the angle FH plane and cella nasion line. Average value is about 60 degree. This is 60 degree y-axis angle. And its meaning, it increased, the angle increased in class to facial patterns. And clockwise growth pattern, in closed clockwise growth pattern, the angle increased. And AB plane angle, and this is A point, and this is B point, and nasion, pogonion, this is facial plane, and the angle between facial plane and AB plane, this is AB plane angle. This is in a maxillomandibular relationship in relation to facial plane. The negative, the B point, when B point is positioned behind point A, it is negative. And this is negative angle. Okay, it means the retrusive mandible and compared to facial plane. Okay. And cantilever occlusal plane. This is important, I think. The cantilever occlusal plane is occlusal plane to FH plane. The average value is about 9 degrees. It gives a measure of slope of the occlusal plane relative to FH plane. This angle increases in class 2 facial patterns. Okay. The interincisal angle, it is a dental relationship, maxilla and mandible. And incisal occlusal plane angle, and it is confusing. In many articles says and I think it is incorrect. The description is incorrect, but the result value is average about 15 degrees. But when we see this picture, this figure, the occlusal plane and lower incisor, the long axis lower incisor, it is not the 15 degrees, but we can draw the vertical line right to the occlusal plane. Between the right angle vertical line and the long axis of the lower incisor, these angles is the incisor occlusal plane angle. But description, the explanation is not correct, I think. And I think it is not important. Incisor mandibular plane angle, it is confusing also, and it also the mandibular plane, the right angle to mandibular plane, it is vertical to mandibular plane, and vertical line, this vertical line, and between the vertical this vertical line and the long axis of the mandibular lower incisor, the angle is incisor mandibular plane angle. It is, I think it is the same angle, IMPA, incisor mandibular plane angle, about 90 degrees, but it shows about 1 degree, only 1 degree. This means the angle between the right angle and the long axis of the lower incisor. Okay, this is the right angle vertical to the mandibular angle, mandibular plane, and the right angle between the lower incisor, long axis of lower incisor, only 1 degree. So it is confusing. And upper incisor to aponeal line, it is the degree, it means it shows the degree of protrusion of maxillary incisor about 2.7 millimeters. I don't pick up this measure. Okay. My conclusion follows. Nasion A point pogonion and FH plane relationship and straighten a right angle like this. We can see the nasion 8-point Pogonian line is, as we can see, angle of convexity is straight. And this line is vertical to FH plane. It is very important view when we see anencephalometric as anencephalogram in directly we see the straight line lesion A point Pogonian and the right angle FH plane. It is very simple and it is very important view when you see this retrocephalogram. We can get good information and good aspect from the Downs analysis. It is very important. And next, occlusal plane and FH plane relationships about 9 degree. It is also important. I pick up this measure. And thirdly, mandibular plane and lower incisor relationship about right angle. It is also very good point. And fourthly, interincisal angle about 135 degrees. I think we don't need to memorize all the measure of Downs analysis, but these four points are as important, I think. Okay, thank you for listening.